One of the best parts of Colorado is its beautiful freshwater ecosystems. As we go fly fishing in the mountain streams, paddleboard in one of the many lakes, or raft down a river, it is easy to think that these places will always be here, exactly as they are today. However, Colorado's fresh waters are threatened by invasive species. The reality is, these invasive species impact far more than just our pristine rivers and lakes. They also impact our agriculture and our drinking water by clogging water intake pipes and changing water's odor and taste. The good news is, you can directly stop the spread of invasive species by cleaning your watercraft and gear. Invasive species are species that are not naturally found in a particular ecosystem. In this case, Colorado's freshwater ecosystems. These are species that are introduced and then are able to successfully reproduce and grow their populations. In many cases, they have no natural predators, and the animals and plants they eat have no natural defenses against them, so they're able to grow their populations quickly. One of the fastest spreading freshwater invasive species is the New Zealand mud snail. One of the reasons these snails have impacted Colorado's lakes and rivers is that they reproduce by cloning. So it only takes one snail to start a new population. These snails are also voracious eaters, often outcompeting native insects, snails, and fish for food. They also have the ability to close their shells, preventing predation, so they cannot be a food source themselves. The reality is, not only animals, but plants can become harmful invasive species. Eurasian water milfoil can be found throughout many of Colorado's Front Range lakes and reservoirs. This plant spreads by small fragments and creates thick, stringy patches of vegetation that snare in boat propellers and entangle swimmers, proving very dangerous to recreators. These thick patches also create stagnant water that provides breeding habitat for mosquito populations. Zebra and quagga mussels are the fastest spreading and most harmful invasive freshwater species in the United States. However, these species are actually a great example of how Colorado has been successful in stopping the spread of invasive species. While these mussels have spread throughout much of the eastern United States and are abundant in nearby water bodies, such as Lake Powell and Lake Mead, only one lake in Colorado, Highline Lake, is considered infested with zebra mussels, and none have quagga mussels. So how is Colorado working to prevent their spread? And how can you help keep these mussels and other invasive species from damaging the pristine rivers and lakes that we enjoy? Freshwater invasive species can use us, people, to move between water sources. More specifically, they use our gear. When we take our boat or paddleboard out on the lake, or wear our waders into a river while fishing, freshwater invasive species can attach themselves to our gear. This can be hard to detect because many invasive species, such as the zebra and quagga mussels, have larval stages that are invisible to the naked eye. The good news is, we can all help stop the spread of freshwater invasive species. The best way to do this is to clean, drain, and dry your gear. Each time you finish using your gear, from waders to kayaks, rinse off your gear so there's no mud, animals, or plants. Drain all of the water out of or off of your gear and dry your gear completely. Let your gear sit and dry for several days, as species like the New Zealand mud snail can survive on wet surfaces for up to 50 days. In some popular locations, CPW and our partners have provided self-gear cleaning stations to help you clean your gear. There are many great recreational opportunities to enjoy in Colorado's lakes and rivers. That's why it's important to help stop the spread. If you'd like to learn more about how to clean, drain, and dry specific types of gear, such as kayaks, paddleboards, or waders, please click the link in the description below.